shit you gave me is greasy.
Let's have a great show, guys. Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, conversations with...
No, Derek, come on, man. You got to get the lines right. I got it.
Welcome to another edition of Conversations with Two... With...
Are you drunk?
Man, I had a couple shots.
It's random conversations with actors.
I got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another edition of Random Conversations with Actors. Got it.
I think he's dyslexic. I'm sorry about that. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome.
Welcome back to Random Conversations with Actors. I'm your host, Philip Bolden. Here with me today is my guest, Aaron Grady. We're sponsored by Essential Water.
No, we're not. No, we're not.
Whose proprietary process turns water from any source into supercharged ionized alkaline water.
What is he talking about?
It's Essentia. It's essential. All right, let's get on to it. Aaron Grady, what's popping, bro?
I'm feeling good, man. Welcome to Random Conversations with Actors. I don't, usually this goes differently. Listen, I'm Aaron Grady. Most of the ladies know me better as Chocolate Stroke. You see it. And today I'm with my dog, man, Philip Bolden, the most talented and interesting black man I know. He's also my castmate on the TV show Millennials. Check us out.
This is all
Big Phil, talk to me. How
my
you feeling,
G,
man?
What's happening, bro?
Why are your hands moist?
Why are yours?
Let's not talk about it.
Yeah, forget that.
Philip, man, talk to me. How you feeling today?
Hey, man, you know what? Everything is everything. I'm alive. The sun is shining, you know? I'm doing good. I'm doing good. How are you, man?
Sorry, my lips were chapped. We're going to get to that. If you guys are unfamiliar with who Philip Bolden is, well, you're disrespectful. But don't worry. We're going to refresh your memory. You want to hit the strip club after this?
After. Right now.
Let's go.
Through this.
Okay.
Okay.
The strip club was crazy, man.
It was
man.
Lit.
Woo!
Yep. Hey, thanks for lending me that 20K.
You,
really appreciate you.
You probably need to go get an STD test. I saw what you was doing. Anyway, Okay. Welcome back to Random Conversations with Actors. You see who he is now. You see it on the shirt. Can I get a round of applause for Philip Bolden real quick? Don't be rude. Woo. Thank you.
Hey, appreciate you.
Thank you. I'm here with my dog, Philip Bolden, and now it's time to talk about the full story, the full journey,
Ooh. And
learn about the guy
behind
the movie. Philip Bolden.
So,
how did you become an actor?
So, me and my parents, I say me and my parents, I was a baby. I wasn't involved in the decision. But they moved out here in 98. I was only 2 going on 3. So I don't remember anything about that time besides us being in a U-Haul and my dad's credit card actually being expired. But
the trenches.
Nobody knew.
Okay.
Like, we were able to rent the U-Haul, get out here, and it was only when we were out here they were like, oh, this card should not have worked. Won't he do it?
Yes, he will.
Won't he do it? The story goes, because again, I just turned 3.
An infant.
Just turned 3.
Okay.
We were at, I think, the Sherman Oaks Mall.
Galleria.
Yeah. And somebody approaches and is like, hey, your kid's cute. Wanna put him in commercials? And my parents are like, get the hell away from us. Stranger danger.
Sounds rapey.
Like, literally, come to LA, the first thing that happens is a suspect white woman comes up and is like,
fresh meat.
Cute kid. I'm like, wow, okay. Get this, we heard stories about this.
Hey, if this is how you felt, how did they then convince you guys? Is the air conditioning on? Oh, that's the heat. That's nice. It was 37 this morning.
Why
did you feel that?
Why are you not wearing more layers?
Well, I have a jacket in here. I might put it on.
They've seen the shirt, man.
Well, I just want them to know it's you. You know what I mean? That's you over here. Is she single? Tell me after. We'll talk about it later. U-Haul
truck to the mall to being scouted by an agency. They found out it was reputable. They were actually an agency. Osprey.
Same.
Right?
Wow.
Yeah.
Life is so funny.
Was it
Cindy?
Yeah. Cindy? I mean, it wasn't her herself who was scouting me in the mall.
Got it.
Somebody worked for it. Yeah.
Okay. Shout out to Cindy Osbrink. If you a real OG
actor, you know
who Cindy Osbrink is.
But yeah, I wound up going to the agency and like they take me to the back to like do some kind of reading or something. I don't remember. I just turned 3. My memory doesn't go back that far. My mom's like, I was back there for five 5 minutes, she starts panicking. It's like, what are they doing to my baby back there? I'm gonna go back there again. My dad's like, hey, calm down, hold on, chill out. We just got here.
Does she really yell that aggressively? She sounded like DMX in your impersonation just now.
No.
Okay. Exactly. Rest in peace to DMX.
Yeah, rip. Rip.
I didn't like that at all.
Okay.
Keep going.
I come
You're
out,
now signed Osbourne.
I come out the room and I'm signed.
Boom.
I think a week later, I book a national commercial, which is a McDonald's commercial. I'm 3 years old. Get to eat a lot of French fries. Very fun for a three-year-old. But yeah, that's
a lot of money too.
That's how that started.
Okay.
Long story short, I don't even remember.
So your parents put you in acting. You were basically discovered at random by an agent in the mall.
Yeah. So it wasn't even like them putting me in it. It was just like God just being like, you.
Did they make the right decision? Are you, because now you've lived the life of an actor since you were 3 years old. Without that moment, if they say no, where does your life go? Who are you right now?
Damned if I know. I'm really not sure. I don't know. I might have gotten into like video game development or something like that. Because I like video games as a kid.
There it is.
But.
That makes sense.
No. There's some judgment behind your
eyes. No, I'm just saying, you know. You look like you're really good at tech. Big Phil.
Sup?
Tell me what it was like on the set of Are We There Yet? What was it like working with Ice Cube?
So the set of Are We There Yet, it was pivotal in my development as a person. Yeah, it was just very, very important for me. It was really, really good time. This was back when they shot a movie. They shot a movie like you were there for a while. None of that. Let's get the hell out of here as soon as we can.
2 week movie shoot.
Yeah, for real.
How long was the shoot?
So we were there from October, I think. October or November of 2003 to March of 2004.
Why did it take that long?
It's like half a year. Well, I guess there was also holiday in the middle of it, you know, we had the Christmas and all that. But they were just taking our time. You know, just making a movie.
And how was Ice Cube?
No, he's good. He's great. He was like
not aggressive.
No,
he was scary.
No,
kind-hearted,
fatherly.
Wow.
Yeah, I know.
He made Fuck the Police.
Yeah.
Then he made Are We There Yet?
Then he made
the
Are We
There Yet?
The
man is versatile.
He was always looking out for us. You know, making sure we had everything we needed. He was joking with us in between takes and stuff like that. Like. Cool dude. Give me a PS2 at the end of the thing.
How you said it was the most important part of your development as a person. Why?
I mean, a lot of things happened while I was on the set. It wasn't just in the shooting of the film, although that's a big part of it. But it was also like I was first introduced to Prince. Not introduced to Prince, but to Prince's music. that would have been okay.
It's no way you should say the sentence like that. It's just no way you should have said it and made the entire audience think that and then take it back. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, so that's when I first
met Michael
Prince.
Jackson.
This is when I first met
his
Prince.
Album. I bought his album. Okay. Ridiculous.
All right, okay.
You met Prince.
Let me take that one back.
Okay, start over. Just try again.
So this is the first time that I was introduced to Prince's music.
Much better. Not sure why you didn't do that the first time.
I was first introduced to Prince's music.
Okay.
There was a period where we had like a lot of downtime. Mm-hmm. And
Ice Cube was on set. Are We There Yet? Listening to Prince? Is that where the story is going? This is a weird story.
So Cube wasn't there at the time. He wasn't with us while this was going on. It was me, my parents, Alicia, played my sister, her mom, her family, and Gary, our third AD, was hula hooping in the rain. That's a whole story.
Somebody got to investigate this set. Seriously, where's the dude from Dateline NBC? Chris Hansen.
How is that? Hold on.
Hula hooping on set shirtless. Did you hear him say shirtless? Was it just me?
We were listening to Prince.
Oh, yeah.
In Vancouver, Canada.
Thank you.
We had a lot of downtime, so we just go through his entire catalog.
You and who?
Were you not listening to what I just said?
I zoned out a little bit. Who was he listening to him with? Who heard his answer?
Who was I listening to him with?
Nobody knows. Who?
He said O'Shea. You was not there. These people aren't listening to me.
This is a terrible story.
Hey, why am I here?
Fuck this story.
Why am I here?
God damn. Nobody in the room knows. Philip Bolden, ladies and gentlemen.
All right. Man, the hell with this?
Big Philly.
Yo.
Tell me about your transition from child actor to adult actor.
Hit my teenage years, okay. Got a lot of acne, you know?
Oh, I'm so sorry.
It was very awkward for a while. And from then, I was just, you know, just taking classes, going through high school and stuff like that. And then I was 17. I graduated from high school a year early because I was done.
Same.
So I was like, okay, cool. Let me just move on to college. I'm 16 going on 17. I'm like, hey, I think maybe I want to take this acting thing seriously. Let me go to a drama school instead of just college, you know, four-year college for the sake of it. I auditioned for Juilliard. I was 16 going on 17. It's the only school I auditioned for. I was like, cool, I'm definitely going to get in. You know? I show up to the audition, do the audition. I'm 16 doing Othello, like crying my eyes out, doing Othello. It must have been a very strange sight.
Wish I could have been there.
No, you don't.
Okay.
I didn't get in.
Sorry.
Which is why you wish you would not have been there.
I didn't want to see you fail. I thought the story was going somewhere successful.
No, I failed.
Okay.
I failed. Well, I fell flat on my face.
Jesus.
I had to drive all the way up to San Francisco to take the audition and then didn't get in, like walk back to the hotel. Almost got run over by a car.
This was the worst day of your life.
Oh, it was horrible. Because I was like, I was just like, I don't know. It's like, I have to take a gap year now. Because this is the only school I have applied for.
So what happened next?
My mom's awesome. My mom found a program.
My mom.
Hello, mom. Love you.
I love you too.
Yeah, let's. Hey, dad.
What up, pops? Mm-hmm. Platonically, mm-hmm. Do your thing.
Unprofessional black people. Nah, forget this.
No.
I'm gone, bro.
She's real thick. Does that help?
All right, so
see what,
I was saying.
See what I mean?
So my mom, she found a program in Oxford, England that, you know, it's called BADA, British American Drama Academy. They do a thing for American students, mostly, who want to come to the country and study abroad for a summer.
Wow.
So I had an audition for that, but I actually got into that one. So I spent 3 weeks in Oxford in 2012. And I was just like, well, I kind of like it over here.
Right.
Maybe I'll apply for schools in England. So I take my gap year. Fantastic gap year. Beautiful.
Fantastic, he said.
Amazing.
Okay.
It was the first time kind of in my life where I was just able to just sit home for a long period of time and just do nothing.
Freedom.
Do absolutely nothing.
The best.
It was great.
I tell people all the time, my favorite thing to do is nothing.
It's nothing.
Not sleep, but to just be alive and have nothing to do.
Yeah, just be.
I'm laying
Enjoy
here.
Enjoy being.
Probably naked. With a thick one with me. Sorry.